This is Radio New Vegas, and I'm your host, Mr. New Vegas. And in case you're wondering if you've come to the right place, you have. We've got some news for you coming right up. A hostage crisis between the NCR and the Great Khans was resolved peacefully when a third-party negotiator successfully secured the hostage's release. One more story for you. Witnesses report a huge object or creature surfacing in Lake Mead. So far, photos of the so-called Lake Mead monster are grainy and underexposed. This program was brought to you by Gamora. Gamora, it'll be our secret.
You know, it's funny Miss New Vegas just said Gamora when, you know, we just finished stuff in Gamora and also are in Gamora itself. But anyways, hey everybody, TBGhunter here, and welcome back to more Fallout New Vegas. Last time I took some drugs, got really high. We found some axe for the Topps Casino, and we thwarted the plans of the bosses here in Gamora and installed Kachinko as the new overboss. Now, you might be wondering why we're back in Gamora after I just finished everything that here for the NCR. Well, there's an unmarked quest, well, not really an unmarked quest, but a really easy missable quest. Kachinko. Gamora is going to be a failure with you in charge, isn't it?
The Legion is moving some new tough muscle into the area. NCR better keep their heads down.
Yeah, NCR's also got some tough muscle coming in as well. Me! We need to go out to the courtyard because that is where the quest is. I guess you get a little bit of an increment to come here because of the receptionist saying to pay this place a visit. But the courtyard, it's nothing special. I mean, it's very kinda green mixed in with brown, but what we need to do is we need to find a working girl. Not for that reason, as some people probably expect me to, but for another reason, and I believe she is over here.
Hey there, sugar. I'm Dazzle. What can I do for you? Or to you? You're so handsome, I might just give you a discount.
Sorry, I am taken.
Well now, that's unusual. Normally, no one cares enough to ask. To be honest, I don't rightly know. My mama was from around these parts. I can remember her face, but not her name. More than I can remember of my daddy, I guess. We lived in Westside before the Omertas bought me. As bad as it can be some days in here, it's better than living in that dump.
I guess you really didn't enjoy West Side Story. That's not who I wanted to come talk to. Arcade just does not give a shit when it comes to crossing a pool and being modest. I also decided to give him the Remnant's power armor just, you know, we're going to be doing a little bit of fighting in this video, so, you know, it'd be worth arming him up a bit. God. Also, for some reason, the Smitty special he was carrying got lost from the end of the last video. Like, I don't know if that was like the noise I heard and just somehow the Smitty special decided to just disappear from this world entirely, but yeah.
That fiend leader shouldn't have messed with our great army.
Can you see anything through that, ma'am? I mean, I know there's like a little holes in there, but doesn't that get a little irritating to see? Or I guess, irritating to see? Oh god, I'm horrible. Alright, so where is this person I need to talk to? She's around here somewhere. You? No, that's just a gambler. Maybe it's at night that I need to come talk to her. Go in here. Maybe she's in a room. Oh. Arcade. No one's home, apparently. Just get a face full of fan. Maybe I should wait till nighttime. You know what? I'll do that. PM seems like a nice time. And I don't think anyone's ever on the second floor balcony, so let's head down here. We're looking for a particular working girl because she is the one to initiate this quest line. And if I can actually find her, damn it. Okay, so something. Man, that girl can electric slide like no one else. Something is a bit different from when I started. As you can see, me and Arcade look nothing like we did in the very start of this video. What happened is I had to roll back a save temporarily to be able to show off this quest, because completing how little we know, or basically the quest that involves taking down the Omertas, can cause this quest to completely glitch out and be able to render it completely unplayable. So let's head over here. This is who I've been looking for to talk to.
Let me guess. You've heard about the mistress who makes all your fantasies come true. So you followed the call of your desires, all the way to the arms of Joanna. Moi. Now that you've found me, I wonder, do you have what it takes?
Well, I always have what it takes.
Oh, confident. I like that. So, what do you want to do with what you've got?
Something that is not at all PG. The better question is, what are you gonna do with it?
Oh my, aren't you something else? I guess you'll have to see for yourself what I can do, huh? Consider it on the house, honey.
Alright, lead the way.
Follow me, hun.
Units our way, right as we speak.
Watch this video get age restricted just for this interaction alone. The things I do to show off the game in its entirety. But don't worry, I got plenty of drugs that we can take that will hopefully make me forget about this terrible ordeal that's going to happen Bitter tonight. Springs. And I'm not talking about what's going on in the bedroom. Alright, let's get down to brass tacks.
Come here, baby. I'm all yours. Are you ready to be all mine?
Ma'am, you really need college.
All right, honey. What do you want to know?
I'd like to know more about you.
Yes.
Contacted pupils, involuntary spasms, medics kills quickly. Joanna, I can help.
I didn't think it showed. I guess that it's worse than I thought.
What happened to you?
I don't know what's happening to me. I can't feel a goddamn thing anymore. Empty and poisoned like the wasteland. I'm afraid I won't make it out of here. Not without Carlitos. If the Medex doesn't kill me first, Cacino or another Omerta will. I look pathetic, huh? The great Joanna. And now, I don't even know why I'm telling you this.
Tell me a little bit about Carlito.
He's a filthy monster. I've been with perverted men, but Cacino's
not
done
Carlito,
things
Cacino.
To me that even other Omertas would also want to kill him if they knew what he does. He's broken so many of their rules that I don't know how he still breathes.
Where are the Omertas ruling Gamora?
They run the place as a center for all their dirty scams and extortions. Gambling, sex, drugs. They'll use whatever works to exploit your weaknesses. Hooker, customer, it doesn't matter. Everyone here's a pawn to the Omertas. Playing and dying by their rules.
Alright, what about Carlito's story?
He was an Omerta that fell in love with me. They don't ever mix with people outside the family, you know? He was planning to escape with me, but Cacino found out about us. So he did something, talked, I don't know. And Carlitos disappeared.
Cacino talked about Carlito broke the Omerta's rules?
Cacino doesn't give a shit about rules, only cares to feed his perversions. He lusted for me. He's done things to me. Look, I'm stuck here. I know that. Carlitos is the only thing that kept me going. And now I don't have anything left.
What if he's still alive?
If he's alive, he's long gone. The Omertas want him dead now. If you meet him anywhere, I'd do anything to get him back and escape this hell. Although I'm not keeping my hopes up.
If he lives, I'll find him for you.
Hun, nobody's given me a free thing before. What's it going to be for you? Caps? Sex? Straps? What?
Hmm. Ma'am, you really need college.
What? Are you serious? Well, I'm not complaining, hon. Thanks so much for your help.
I feel like this is like an old movie come to life. Bye-bye, love. The whole quest is basically an alternate way you could get the dirt on what Kachino's been doing behind the family's back. And that's the only reason why this quest exists, if you're not good at stealth, to pickpocket his journal or find his other journal. The thing about it is, it's a very backtrack heavy quest. Like, more than I would say chapter... what was it? 5, 6 of Thousand Year Door with all the backtracking you're going to be doing. And you remember how much backtracking I did when I was back in that series. But for now, where we need to go is to Vault 21, because that is actually where Carlito is hiding out. Hey Sarah, still don't have your vault stuff yet. I'm getting to work on that. Don't worry, I'll be right back. Down into the depths of the vaults. We actually haven't explored Vault 21 at all this entire series outside of the gift shop. So I'm going to activate the marker just because it's a bit of a maze like all vaults are, and I think I know where Carlito hides out down here, but I could be wrong knowing me. So I just want to have this as a little bit extra insurance just to make sure I know where he is. But I believe that he hangs out in the 21 cafeteria. Or maybe the commerce area, who knows. I also know there's like a little like squatter area that you could go to, but nope, there he is.
Hey, do you mind? I'm trying to drink myself to the ground right here. Scram.
I'm here on Joanna's behalf.
What did you say? I mean, Joanna sent you. Please, tell me, is she all right? When did you see her? What does she have to say?
She doesn't know you're still alive.
Then she has to know. I'm ready to help her escape once and for all. Am I even scared of Kachino and all those fuckers? Joanna and I are dead anyway if we don't get the hell out of here.
Why don't you get her out of Gamora?
What, you think I can just waltz in there and take her away? She's their doll now, okay? Besides, I step in Gamora and I'm as good as dead, you hear? You don't just leave the Emeritus unless it's in a body bag.
Alright, I'll let her know.
Deal. Come back with news soon, you hear? Delnek?
Actually, I want to check out something. I want to check and see if the location of the snow globe that's in the vault, is it behind a locked door, or does it need a key to get into? This door? No, it's not this door. It has to be this door. The lock. And it's behind a locked door. But yeah, there is the strip snow globe, and that's the last snow globe in the game. Now, of course, I'm probably going to be doing this the legitimate way back in the main story LP. But it's just nice to know that you can always just come down here if you want to just bypass the side quest to get into that room. Ma'am, I come bearing good news.
Hey there, gorgeous. I knew you'd be back soon enough.
I've brought a message from Carlito.
What? Have you seen him? Have you talked to him?
No, I pulled this message out of my ass. What do you think? He wants to get you out of here.
Look, we can't talk here. If you think you can help me, follow me to my room, please.
All right, lead the way.
Follow me, hun. Hey, what's up?
All right, about Carlito.
Yes?
He wants to get you out of here.
He does? Wait, this changes everything. I can't leave my girls here. And where would we go even if we escape? No, it's too risky. We'll all end up dead.
Trust me, I'll keep you safe.
You sound so sure. Damn it all. You better not make me regret this later. But the Emeritus will want us dead. What are we going to do about that?
You'll never see them again. You have my word.
To be free, and with Carlitos again. Tell him that never mind. Let Carlitos know that we'll be ready when you are.
Don't worry, I'll tell him that you're happy to hear from him.
Thank you so much for your help.
Back to Vault 21! I told you this is going to be a lot of backtracking. Carlito, I come bearing news.
Hey, it's you. What's the news?
It's about Joanna.
Hey, that's great. What's going on?
She's happy to hear from you and wants to escape Gamora.
She is? Listen, no time to waste. Help her get to Freeside. That's our ticket out of this fucking city. I'll meet you there between midnight and dawn. But we could use some backup. We only got one chance to get this right, you hear? These guys in Freeside, good shots, right? They owe me big time. Tell them that Carlitos is back to collect his chips. They'll know what to do.
Alright, and how do I get her out of Gamora?
She'll have to go disguised. Gamora's packed around midnight, and the bouncers won't notice just another patron leaving the joint.
Alright. And where in Freeside will you meet us?
I'll be near the entrance, but I need to keep out of sight. The Emeritus have contacts, and they're still looking for me.
Alright.
Damn it! You're gonna leave me hanging, huh? Hey, it's you.
Oh, damn it. Alright. Okay, I'm on.
Alright.
Alright, let's see. Optional, go get backup before attempting to escape. Fight two guns for hire. Do I need to go back to Gamora itself? Because if so, I'm gonna be angry. I'm angry! Oh. That's not the right way. I guess I'll meet you at the Atomic Wrangler because that's where we need to go get those guns for hire. And I went the complete wrong direction. Alright, so we are back in the Atomic Wrangler. Here are the two guns for hire.
The kids are working with NCR? What's this place coming to?
Let me guess. You want to know my secret? How I got my beard to grow in so thick.
What's your trick?
Sorry, but I can't tell you that. Trade secret.
Why'd you ask me? Does the name Carlito ring a bell?
Depends on why you're asking.
He's ready to cash in his chips.
I see. Well, he can count on Little Beard and me for an assist. Tell us where and when, and we'll be there.
The where is Freeside, and now would be a good time.
The Beards will be there.
Hello. Just talk to Big Beard next to me, pal. Whoever's got the biggest whiskers does the talking.
So if you're Little Beard, you're Big Beard. If I join you guys, will I be Middle Beard? I mean, I got a nice little scruff growing right now. I think I could roll with you guys. Alright, we're back, and hopefully for the last time.
Hey, what's up?
Got news from Carlito.
Yes?
You meet us in Freeside around midnight. I'll sneak you out in the disguise.
Okay, I got clothes I can use for that. When you give the word, I'll let the other girls know and we'll meet you at the lobby. Hey, what's up?
Are you ready to get out of here?
It's not a good...
Oh, wait. It's way too early for this. We need to wait till midnight. 5, 6, 7. This may take a while. 11, 12. There we go.
Hey, what's up?
Okay, now are you ready to leave?
I'm ready. Just give the word and we'll meet you at the...
Alright, let's do this.
Okay.
Not really much of a disguise. I mean, the hat kind of gives it away. I mean, have you thought about wearing a trench coat? Even though, actually, no way trench coats are in this game. The Rangers wear them. Go meet them up in the lobby, and then get the hell out of here. Because I will be done with Gamora! Unless I decide to come back here and play some casino games, which I highly doubt, unless people ask for it. Alright, ladies, you ready to get out of here?
Come on. People are looking at us.
You ready to get out?
We're ready. Let's get the hell out of here before they recognize us.
Alright, well, let's head out.
It's now or never. Let's go.
No more dilly-dallying. Of course, they gotta be slow as molasses to leave. I mean, it's not like we're in a hurry or anything. It's not like we have a time limit of getting there before daybreak. Of course, they have teleporting technology that makes them leave the casino so early. Wait, what? What? Alright, now it seems like I've managed to get everything to run smoothly. I guess because I decided to leave without them that she got caught as she was trying to make her escape. I guess that would have made it. I'm going to still count that as a glitch because this mission seems to be very glitchy in terms of how easy you can fail it. Don't stop. No, run. Yes, run. No, don't stop. No, don't bunch up there. Run. You know what? Just as an extra precaution, gonna have sleepy time armed with me. I'm gonna let you three go ahead of me so that way I don't end up failing the quest for a third time. And you might be wondering, well, you already failed it only once. What happened? Well, I also had a second failure in the middle of redoing this quest just so that I could finally get to the ending of it to show it off. The things I do to entertain people. As much as I love this game, I wish Obsidian would have worked out on this quest a bit more and flushed out some of the other ones and made them less buggy and glitchy.
You've made it. Thanks so much for your help. I owe you more than... Wait, what's that?
What's what? Ah, shit. Of course, it's always something.
Well, well, well. If it isn't our whore Joanna. And I don't believe this. Carlitos. We had you and the whore clocked from the start. We thought Carlitos would be long gone by now. He should have fled with the caps he stole from the family. We Omerdas don't forget. And now's time to pay for your offense.
Sir, your voice and your face does not match whatsoever. Your boss will hear about how you spoiled the mission.
What mission? What are you talking about?
Carlitos is trading what he stole for Joanna. I was hired to see that he does.
All the dough? Cuccino once said this trader flipped with thousands off the record. Why wasn't I informed?
Your boss kept it a secret. Carlito would not have dealt directly with the Omertas.
I see, yeah. He knows what we usually do to traders. But all that profit is well worth sparing his miserable life. Okay, carry on. And we've never been here, you understand? Boss doesn't need to know about this.
You got that right. Now get the hell out of here before it's sleepy time for you idiots.
I don't know how we pulled this off. For a minute there, I thought we were not going to make it. Without you, we'd have been in the losing end. Thank you so much for your help, friend.
It was my pleasure.
I take care of my debts. How can I repay you, friend?
I think 400 caps is a fair deal.
We have a deal, then. Okay, friend. I hope to see you again. Far away from this place.
You truly are something else. Those Omertas look like they were going to kill Carlitos on the spot. I have nothing to give you except my thanks. And, well, if I were you, I'd not mess around with the Omertas anymore. But listen to this. Cuccino has said things that make me think there's a big and nasty operation in the works. Something about getting even with Mr. House. Just thought you'd like to know. Okay. I'm getting Carlitos as far away from here as possible. Hope to see you again. Bye.
I highly doubt we're going to see each other again, but thanks for the information, even though I really don't need it anymore. And with that, they head off to Willamette, Colorado, where Carlitos accidentally causes a zombie virus and pretty much wipes out the entire city. And by accident, I mean on purpose, because life has dealt him a bad hand multiple times. It's now time for him to get payback in. What the hell is... Why is there just a dead body right here? Oh, that's the freeside thug that was killed when I came back here a second time. Alright, so with that quest out of the way, it's... God, you two. I appreciate you being able to take out people behind me without having to worry about them, but seriously, the camera needs to stop. Time to go back to the future, alright? Let's go. Oh, it's nice to finally be back in my suit and, you know, to have my funky fresh pit boy back. And, wow, the screen's even gold, I didn't even know that. Now that all that business with Gamora has been settled in the past, let us head off to the last casino, the Ultra Lux. Very fancy, even with its light-up stairway. I feel like there needs to be a Casio playing every time I take a step up this thing. I'm not gonna lie, Ultra Lux, very ritzy, but also very creepy. And you'll get why.
Beg your pardon, but could I trouble you to turn over your weapons?
Could I trouble you to blow it out your ass?
How frightfully uncouth. I'm afraid I must insist you relinquish your weapons.
I can't even keep my holdout weapons because you need a lot of sneak to be able to keep even the bare minimum of your holdout weapons. Fine, here you go.
My deepest apologies for the slightest inconvenience. You have my assurance that everything will be returned upon your departure. But we simply can't have anyone waving their weapons around in the hotel. It's not the atmosphere we wish to cultivate. Please, enjoy your stay.
Where did you take my weapons?
They'll be handled with the utmost security in our bank.
Alright. Better be careful. The weapons are worth a lot of money. Wait a second. You let this guy keep his shotgun. Why can't I keep my weapons, huh? Better have a good reason for carrying a shotgun around here.
You watch yourself around, Mr. Gunderson.
Watch yourself.
Looks like the war's ratcheting up. I hear the NCR's bringing in elite
NCR, troops. NCR, Legion, they're all bringing their elite troops. You get an elite troop, and you get an elite troop.
Beg your pardon, stranger, but I'm looking for someone. You ain't seen a young man with dark brown hair and a white hat on lately, have you?
No. I mean, I'm wearing a hat, but not a white hat, sorry.
Ain't nobody got one darn piece of news about my boy. Not one lousy speck of information. Ain't got one Brahmin unaccounted for across a dozen ranches. But I'm here for an hour and my own son just up and disappears on me.
So you're a rancher?
Yep. Got a whole mess of Brahmins to my name. Bighorners, too. Used to just have the one ranch. But land was easy to grab before the soldiers moved in. Before I knew it, I was running one of the biggest ranching operations east of California. Now, everywhere I go, folks I never even met shake my hand and call me Mr. Gunderson. Don't quite know what to make of that.
So, why is your bodyguard allowed to have a gun?
Made me a special arrangement with the hotel. They want to do business with me, they got to play by my rules. A lot of people out there resent success, might want to take a swipe at me. This makes them think twice. If I'd have been thinking, though, I'd have had him watching my boy instead. Then none of this would have happened.
All right. Well, you lost your son?
My boy, Ted. He was right here. I didn't leave him but a minute. I told him to stay put while I talked some things over with the White Glove folks. He was never one to stay tied down to a spot, though. Gets that from his mother. Got most of my staff out looking for him now. I'd be out myself, but I keep hoping he'll show up back here. Of course, if he does that, I'll whoop him till his skinny hide turns to leather for putting me through this. But that don't mean I wouldn't be grateful.
All right, well, I'll be sure to keep an eye out for your son.
I'd be more than happy to have you. Heck, I'll hire anybody with a pair of legs and at least one good eye at this point. There'd be a lot of money in it for you if you can get him back to me safe. And if he ain't, you can bet I'll pay for the names of the sons of bitches responsible.
What business do you have here in the hotel?
That's between me and the White Glove Society. But let's just say they control the food supply around here, and I got lots of food to give. But that ain't as welcome as you might think.
All right. You said something about white gloves?
That's what they call themselves, the folk that run this place. They're the ones dressed all fancy with their bow ties and shiny dresses. Some of them got masks, too. Real hard to trust folks like that. A couple of them show their faces, and that's who I do my business with. I don't talk to none of the other ones. I'll be here.
Well, it is time to go beyond the beef. And where is the beef, you might ask? It's in the mailbox. All right, so let's track this quest so we can get started. Beyond the beef, ask around the Ultra Lux for information regarding Gunderson's disappearance, and get Ted back to his father if he is still alive. I looked ritzy enough to be able to run this place. I think no one's gonna take a second look at me. Let's get to know the people, see if they have anything to say.
Humbly at your service.
Unfortunately, this guy's an idiot, and I can't really ask him about anything. There is a safe that has my guns in it. I could go for.
Good day.
Good day, sir. I'm looking for someone.
Oh, well, it's a big hotel. You should talk to Marjorie. She's in charge, and she can probably help you find anyone you might need. She usually works at the front of the Gourmand. She likes to see how people respond to it. You can get to the Gourmand from the lobby here. It's a big set of double doors on the first floor of the eastern side. Can't miss it.
How is everyone around here dressed up wearing masks?
Those are all members of the White Glove Society. Our founder Marjorie gave us all a dress code. There's only one rule to it. In her words, we must dress in such a way that no one can be said to have dressed better than us. As for the masks, I'm not allowed to tell you. We're sworn to secrecy. Actually, that's not true. That's just what we're supposed to say. I think Marjorie likes them for the mystery they create, and the way they make it clear that we're different from everyone else. But you didn't hear that from me.
Oh, so it's like an eyes wide shut thing here. Creepy! Where's your mask?
Must have forgotten to put it on. How embarrassing. Farewell.
Farewell, good sir. You've got a top hat. You look important. Actually, kind of look like Walt Disney.
How may I be of service, sir?
Have any work that needs to be done? I'm always in the room for some caps.
No, not from the likes of you, I'm afraid. I don't think you'd have the stomach for it. Better look elsewhere.
What about your organization? I'd like to know more about it.
My, such a popular question. I suppose it is only natural to see us and wonder what it is that makes us special. The White Glove Society has only just made itself known to the public, of course, but our pedigree was established over generations. Were we always so refined? I'd be lying if I said yes. But I've always felt we were destined for a place atop modern society. And now, here we are. Not everyone can wear the finest clothes and eat the finest foods, obviously. That's just the reality we live in. But surely we can agree that the most tasteful, sophisticated people are the most deserving. And that's what the White Glove Society is all about.
Interesting.
Indeed.
Interesting. Very well. Whoa, what the hell was that?
Top Shelf is the premier bar on the Strip. The drinks are overpriced.
You looking to start something, buddy? You're the closest one to me, so you had to be the one who pushed me. Anything in the wardrobe? Yeah, just some dirty clothes. Why is there a wardrobe in a lobby, to be exact? I guess a coat hanger? Even though there's not really any coats in this game, if it was pre-war stuff. Madam?
Welcome to the Ultra Lux. I do hope it exceeds your every expectation.
Only if you have steamed crab. Do you work here?
I do. But one can hardly call it work. I think of myself as a caretaker rather than a common laborer. I suppose it is a labor of love if it can be called labor at all. We at the White Glove Society are all responsible for maintaining the beauty and class of the Ultra Lux. And as its founder, I suppose it falls to me to decide how we go about it.
Ed Gunderson said he was here to talk business with you. What business would that partake be?
What else? Mr. Gunderson and I have been discussing his livestock. It's put us in a rather delicate position, you see, his coming here. Not that we aren't grateful for his generous offer. But our executive chef, Philippe, has transformed Brahmin steak into a delicacy. He really is a genius. Everyone wants it. But a delicacy is just that. Delicate. If everyone can get it, it ceases to be a delicacy. It becomes a perfectly ordinary staple. And if the gourmand served staples, it would no longer draw the caliber of people it deserves. It would be a diner or a family restaurant.
Oh, the whore!
So as much as we'd all love for there to be enough steak for everyone, I'm afraid there are more important things to consider.
I was looking for someone who went missing recently.
This again? I thought this was all settled. I answered every one of that investigator's questions to his satisfaction and gave all the help I could. I know our reputation hasn't always been spotless, but that's all in the past now. How some people can't get over it is beyond me. For the last time, the White Glove Society has never and will never consume human flesh for any reason. It's written in the charter.
Wait, what? Who did you talk to about a disappearance and also human flesh?
There was an investigator who came through here last week. He'd been hired by a young man whose bride-to-be went missing during their stay here. Well, you can already guess what probably happened, can't you? It seems perfectly likely that she got cold feet and ran off. And that young groom just didn't have a clue, the poor dear.
Well, I'm investigating someone else. A man. He recently went missing.
A man? Well, then this... Well, this can't be. Two disappearances in my hotel? What will people say?
Oh,
I'm going to have a word with my staff about security on the premises. Whether these people are found or not, our guests simply must feel safe in their own rooms.
Indeed. Is there any way I could talk to this investigator?
Why, yes, I think so, if he hasn't checked out yet, that is. I had our maitre d' Mortimer offer him a complimentary room for as long as it took for him to be satisfied. You see, the White Glove Society remains the very picture of courtesy, even in the face of such impolite accusations. We have nothing to hide here.
Hmm. And yeah, the White Glove Society used to eat human flesh?
Now, didn't I already tell you that we don't do that sort of thing? We do not engage in cannibalism here under any circumstances.
I use past tense, not present tense.
Though we haven't always been the White Glove Society. There was another time, a dark time, when we went by a different name. But that's all changed now.
A Brown Nose Society.
Evolved past such base impulses since settling into our new home. I've seen to it that those days are behind us.
Hmm. All right, then. I'm not going to say I eat human flesh. That's disgusting. But we seem to have a lead, so it's better than nothing. Let's go talk to Mr. Mortimer and see what this lead is.
How may I be of service, sir?
I heard the group dines on human flesh. You know what? You said you rented a room out to a private investigator.
Private investigator? Ah, yes, I remember the gentleman. This was about the missing bride. Such an awful thing. I do hope he finds her whereabouts. If I might pry, have you found something that will help his investigation?
Actually, I just need to speak with him.
Of course, of course. Now, ordinarily, we don't give out guest information, but I think, given the circumstances, he'll want to speak with you. Let's see. He hasn't checked out yet. If you head back to the hotel rooms, his will be one floor directly above you after you exit the lobby. I hope we can put this whole matter to rest at last.
Indubitably. All right. This way.
Did you know the strip's all stirred up lately?
Why would the strip be all stirred up? I guess the business with the Omertas finally got out in the strip and that has them up in arms about it? I don't know. This place is very ritzy. This appears to be the door. Mr. Investigator, you. Caruso. My god. So, you think you can silence me, huh? I know too much, do I? Eddie, where the hell are you? I need your help. God, he doesn't even have any eyes! Or I was just looking at an angle. Where the hell is Eddie?
Had enough!
Hopefully this guy has a weapon on him. Matchbook, sunglasses. Damn it.
Come on. Had enough! Here we go.
If only I had a weapon on me. Do I even have a weapon? Nope. Unless I want to take pictures of him. Fuel my camera!
How about these, you know what? First things first. Stimpax. And now, Psycho. Eh, great, I'm addicted.
You like that?
I think I just broke a rib with that punch. Oh, that takes care of him. Oh god, I think I might have snapped his spine while at it. Arcade, how you doing? Need a little help? Very well. Eat my cane! Eddie, you are completely useless. Usually, you're the one who can one-shot everyone, but no, not this time. Oh my god. I'll take his everything. And we'll just put the body in here out of view of the guests. Come on. Get the head. It goes in the room. Anything else? Come on, give me a hand here. Come on, stop dragging it on the ground like it's a snake. Alright, fine. The hand stays, I guess. What a mess this is. Mr. Gannon? It appears that the gloves have come off. There, I made the joke. You happy? Good. I'm never making it again. Let's see what this matchbook has to say. Phone is scrolled across the book and at the back of the matchbook. Steam room, 4 p.m. There, you die in an undignified way. Yep. Just on the safe side, these dress canes. Nope. Want to hotkey it. There. Actually, does the White Glove Society, since it does have a reputation, does it also have, like, fashion clothing? I forget. Fix the mask. There. I look like a fancy, fancy dude. Alright, let's go back to Benny's suit. I know what I didn't even say I was dressed as a member of the White Glove Society. But yes, oddly enough, they do actually have a faction, which is weird because the chairman and the Omertas are not considered a faction, but the White Glove Society is. I never understood why. I mean, the White Glove Society doesn't even have like a big output for the ending of the game, unlike the Omertas do. What time is it? 3. Wait an hour. There. 4. Let's enter the steam room. Very particular. Cowboy hat and some glasses. Hello? Anyone home? Oh, wait. I'd be here. What the hell? What does my Pip-Boy say? It says, this is Steam Room 4 p.m. Meet the investigators, contact the Ultra Room at 4 p.m. Here. Arcade, your armor is too big. Wait, right here.
Oh,
you can be my bodyguard. Maybe if I wait until... Oh, no wonder, it's 4 a.m., not 4 p.m. Got my days and nights mixed up. And just wait a little bit. 3... Alright, there we go. It is you!
Who are you?
You first. Actually, I'm looking for someone who went missing.
So was the man I'm supposed to be meeting here. Where is he?
He couldn't make it. He sent me instead. He might get too jittery if I tell him he's dead.
The devil he did? He was supposed to meet me days ago. Are you in Mortimer's employ then?
Found his matchbook on a body in a hotel room. No, better be even more truthful.
Oh my goodness me. They must know he was talking to someone on the inside. They'll be watching everyone closer now. I knew this was a mistake.
Who are you afraid of?
Mortimer. If he realizes it was me the investigator was planning to meet, he'll have me killed.
So is Mortimer behind the disappearances?
Yes. The White Glove Society strictly forbids eating humans. But we weren't always the White Glove Society. Mortimer and some of the others have regressed to the old ways. They've taken many people over the last few months, but always from Freeside or secluded places where they wouldn't be missed. It wasn't enough. Lately, they've gone for tourists here on the Strip, even in the hotel. I guess that's the hazard of a cannibal becoming a gourmet. It's hard to please a refined palate.
What are you supposed to discuss here?
The girl, the one who disappeared. I know what happened to her.
How do you know what happened to her?
Because I distracted her fiancé while they took her. Well, I'm not proud of it, but I had to. They could see I was having second thoughts. Some of the White Gloves began meeting privately a while back, started talking about how we'd lost our identity. I started attending because I thought it was about changing our politics. Then they started talking about returning to the old ways, and there was no way out. They'd kill me for the things I heard them say.
What about Ted?
He's alive, as far as I know. They're trying to keep him fresh. Mortimer has special plans for him. The White Glove Society has a banquet every night at 7. It's in our private section. Mortimer wants to reintroduce humans into our cuisine. Since eating people is a crime we punish by death, he's going to do it in secret. After everyone has eaten it, he'll tell them. With no real way to punish everyone, in Mortimer's mind anyway, their minds will be open to the idea of eating people as a delicacy.
All right, well, where are they keeping them?
I don't know exactly. I wasn't in on it. I think some of them have stopped trusting me. But you can bet they're keeping them near the gourmand. Our chef, Philippe, has an obsession with fresh ingredients. It'd be back in the members-only section, so you'll have to be careful. Don't be seen, and more importantly, don't let them see Ted in the open. It's guarded both at the lobby entrance and in the access tunnels leading from the main restaurant.
Anything you can do to help me?
I could sponsor you as an honorary member. The White Gloves are always looking for people who can elevate their status. You'd certainly fit the bill with everything you've done around here. Otherwise, you'll have to find some way to get inside quietly. It won't be easy, and it'll be harder still to get them out.
All right, any idea how I could get them out?
Well, they'll all be sampling pre-war wines before the meal. Maybe it's as simple as drugging them. Although, that wouldn't stop any future kidnappings. You'd have to expose Mortimer, but he's going to confess anyway. What if his revelation were a lie? What if no one had eaten human flesh but him? If you could somehow replace Philippe in the kitchen and serve a convincing substitute instead, you could walk Ted right through the middle of that room after Mortimer speaks, and then he'd have some explaining to do. Philippe has been trying to approximate the taste of human flesh for years. He must have a recipe somewhere.
Ted's father's a wealthy man. With his resources, this should be easy to stop.
That may be true, but I wouldn't recommend it. He's built a reputation, and it isn't for calmness and impartiality. He's not what he looks like. They call him Hurricane Heck. The man built his empire by hiring mercenaries to drive off the competition. Lately, he's been attacking our Brahmin suppliers so he can take over their business. He's the sort to pound in a nail with a wrecking ball. If you give him the whole story on this, he'd be liable to raise the entire hotel. And God knows what he'd do to the rest of the Strip.
Wouldn't they punish Mortimer for deception?
They might, but to him, the legacy of returning to the old ways is worth his own life. I don't think he expects it, though. I don't either. Nothing is more important to the society than being on the cutting edge of New Vegas cuisine. Mortimer's idea will appeal to that need. He just has to get them over the taboo.
All right. All right, how do I get in? All right. That's all I need to know.
Let's plan on meeting again as soon as... Wait, did you hear something? Were you followed?
Shouldn't. Oh, shit. Arcade, you had one job! Ow, 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 ow. The plot thickens more and more each day. You know what? Just making sure he doesn't come back as a zombie. Damn it. Well, there goes my only chance of getting in officially. Take that formal wear as well. Just, it's a steam room. He shouldn't be wearing that much clothing. Alright. Well, this is gonna be harder than I thought now. Seems the white gloves are starting to get on to me about finding Heck. Or Ted. And they killed my only witness and only inside man. He said that we should go to the Gourmand area. Was that Gourmand to the Ultra Lux, or what would that way be? That way leads to the members only section. I think members only is probably really heavily guarded. I'm gonna go through the Gourmand instead. I just realized I left Arcade back in the steam room. You know what? It's fine. Eddie, wait here. Make sure no one follows me in. Don't worry about me. I'm just coming back here to wash my hands. Yoop. Don't mind me. Just being a Lux. Oops. Just making sure your lock works fine. And it apparently works very fine. Sneaking around some place like this in a suit is not going to work out right. Well, you know what? I'm going to wear a radiation suit and we're going to go in disguised as the health inspector. Oh my god. Oh, I guess that's one way of cooking beef. Guess that we all know what beef went beyond. Infected Brahmin steak. Ew, some sunset sarsaparilla. I will take that. Always nice to have some sunset sarsaparilla on the hand, just in case anyone leads to a star bottle cap. Your friendly neighborhood health inspector. Hopefully no one heard that. Pre-war book. Sunset sarsaparilla. I don't know why everything is considered stealing in this place. Uh-oh. Don't mind me.
You. What do you think you're doing?
Water main burst upstairs. They set me down to survey the damage.
Curse it all. Your timing couldn't be more atrocious. Just make it quick, all right?
Yes, sir. Don't worry. I'll be in and out like a flash. Ooh, what do we have we here? These wines are set up to be taken by the servers to the banquet. Medicine 7500. Medics required to drug the wine. Nah.
Hello, sir.
Why are you standing still? Do you think the world waits for you while you stand there drooling? Get back out there and get to work.
Who do you think you are talking to me that way?
Who the fuck do you think I am? I'm the fucking god of New Vegas Brahmin fusion cuisine, that's who. No, that doesn't even give me the credit I deserve. I fucking invented edible food. Do you like eating? Good. You owe me your entire goddamn garbage existence.
I think you may have confused me with someone else.
Oh, really? So despite your filthy face and your vacant expression and your complete lack of human dignity, you're telling me you're not a server?
Your predisposition towards me is... towards anger suggests some unresolved issues from your past.
What kind of harebrained fucking psychobabble bullshit is that? I yell at people because I like yelling at people, and because they fucking deserve it. Not because Mumsy and Daddykins didn't hug me enough.
You may be projecting. Tell me more about your parents.
Oh, I see how it is. You think because my father walked out on us when I was 5, now I have to yell at people. Or because my mother was a deranged chem fiend who regularly brought strange men home who told me to call them uncle. Or because my sisters would lock me in a shipping crate when they didn't want me around. And my brother... God, I'd forgotten about that. How could they do that to me? I can't stay here. I need to be alone.
What about the banquet?
Forget about the fucking banquet. You know what? You can do it. You be the star chef. Take my recipes. It won't fill the hole, though. Just remember that. You'll always feel empty.
Well, that was easier than I thought. Guess I don't need this thing. What? Going in, we're going in fancy as hell. My glasses at. Can't see a thing with all these stains. There we go. Hello? Hector? Or Ted? No, he's over there. Where'd Ted go? Oh, he's back here. Or not. I'll take the first aid box, that's for sure. Maybe he was in the other... You know what? I bet he was in that room with the terminal. There he is.
Look, my daddy's gonna kill all you bastards once he finds out what you done to me.
Calm down, I've come to get you out of here.
My daddy sent you? God damn it, I almost died in here. What the hell took you so long? It's just one damn hotel. Who did this to me anyway? They hit me over the head before I got a look at him.
There's no time to explain. Eh, you know what? Better to lay it all out on the table. Some members of the White Glove Society were here and they're gonna eat you.
What in the Sam hell? Eat me? What kind of sick bastards would eat a person? I'll tell you what, as soon as I'm out of here, and my daddy knows the story, you can bet there ain't gonna be no White Hat Society no more.
The White Gloves entirely aren't to blame, just Mortimer and a few others.
To hell with that. You've seen those freaks. They dress the same, talk the same. You can bet they all eat the same, too. They deserve what my daddy's gonna have coming for them.
You know, I could always leave you in here if you aren't gonna listen.
All right. But there's gonna be some justice one way or another. I'll see to that. Let's go. I'll be right behind you.
Very well. Before we do that, let's do a little bit of cooking. Everything necessary to cook a meal here is at your disposal, as long as Felipe isn't here to stop you. Survival 75 or higher required to improvise a meal using no recipe, intelligence 6 or higher, and the recipe required to cook the following recipe. Let's cook some imitation human flesh using recipes. There we go. Get rid of Felipe, use the intercom to call the head waiter. Shit, Ted. Ted, buddy, you need to wait here.
Come on, move it.
Sir?
How may I assist?
It's time to serve the meal.
But no one is in their chairs yet. Surely we should wait until... I'll be ready.
All right, then. I guess we're going to be waiting until 7. Man, it's only a few minutes away. Seriously? Sir?
How many?
It is now 7. Time to service the meal.
At 1.
All right, let's get the hell. Let's sneak out of here. All right, here comes the waiter. And there he goes. All right, looks like he's out of our hair. Let's just, is this the right way? No, it would be that way. Shouldn't see me. Just make our way this way. Here's the waiter. Get through here. Come on, Ted. Where's the door? Where's the door? Where's the door? Fuck it. Waiter still hasn't seen us. That's good. Time to crash a dinner party.
I know I'm not the scheduled speaker, but I have a few words if I may. There was a time not so long ago when we were bound together not as members, but as family, as a clan. And when Mr. House came to us with his proposal, we accepted, knowing we stood to gain much. Little did we know how much we'd lose in the process. As a society, we've endeavored to sample the finest food and drink the world has to offer, but we are living a lie. There is a meat sweeter than the most corn-fed livestock. Most of you have tasted it. All of you have coveted it. Among us, it is a crime to discuss a return to the old ways that unified our people. Tonight, that all changes. The taboo ends. Let me finish, Marjorie. You don't know it yet. But you are all now guilty of a greater crime, one that ordinarily bears the harshest of punishments. Surely that you are all guilty warrants not only universal amnesty, but also a renewed discussion. For our society to be truly elite, we must dine on the most delicious, the most exclusive food known to us. And tonight, for the first time as a society, you are sampling that very dish, the meat we are forbidden to taste, the way it was meant to be eaten. Fellow members of the White Glove Society, bon appetit.
Hold it right there, evil Walt Disney.
Who is this trespasser?
Bad news, Mortimer! No one is eating the boy you kidnapped tonight.
What are you... Why is he there? Who are we eating right now?
Sorry, Mortimer. Secret recipe. It isn't human, though. I can tell you that.
No! These are lies. I never kidnapped anyone. And even if I did, there's no harm done. He's alive, after all.
Too late, Mortimer. You already said too much.
You're all hypocrites. How can you claim to be connoisseurs yet deny yourselves the greatest of all meats? I am ashamed to have once called everyone here family. This isn't over, though. I'll begin anew. The White Glove Society will never achieve the greatness of my new order. You'll all hear from me again.
What are you, a Bond villain? Get out of here before I club you over the head with this walking cane. Ma'am, I do not think that it... Oh, my... Ma'am, I was just kidding about the Eyes Wide Shut party. Wait, Pastor.
Oh my. How unfortunate. And in front of all these people, too. He always was a bit of a pill, Mortimer. He was so pouty when I decided to ban eating people. And now this. I should have paid more attention to the warning signs. Can you imagine what people would have said? Why, it would have been a complete scandal if it weren't for you.
Oh, indubitably, miss. I want to join the White Glove Society. I was told I needed a sponsor.
Why, yes, of course. The White Glove Society is the most exclusive club in all of New Vegas. Perhaps the entire world. It's only natural that you'd need a sponsor from within the club who can vouch for your good name. Originally, we didn't allow anyone else in, you see. Founding members only. We thought exclusivity would make us the envy of everyone who's anyone. And it has. But then I had the idea to allow honorary members. Lower in status, naturally, but it just makes people want to be us even more. And the right people could certainly do wonders for our image. Celebrities, philanthropists, we want only the very best.
Well, how does a war hero sound?
And you most certainly fit the bill. Given your deeds on the Strip alone, I can safely say that you would be a prized addition to our honorary ranks. You have my full support, and you are welcome to join us at our nightly banquets in our special section of the Gourmand. I hope to see you there.
Oh, you will, madam. You will.
Ta-ta.
Ta-ta, good man. Good dear. And now we are idolized by the White Glove Society.
Greetings.
But our quest is not finished yet. We still need to return Ted to his loving father, you know, Wasteland Colonel Sanders. He looks like that. You're better Jeff Bridges. It kind of does remind me of Jeff Bridges from RIPD, if we're going to be exact. Mortimer, you still aren't out of here yet? Get the hell out of this place before I decide to call in the Securitrons. That's right, you better be running. You better run!
I guess those kings finally got who's the real boss around here.
Oh my god. Ted, are you all right?
It's uncanny.
You got me my boy back. I got no words. Now, I hope you didn't do no harm to whoever's responsible for this. I want to skin their hides myself.
Well, he went screaming out into the wasteland, so if you're going to go look for him... that's where you're going to want to look. It was Mortimer, one of the White Gloves, who had Ted taken. He's a cannibal.
Well, that does it. None of them maniacs will ever do business with Hank Gunderson long as they live. Hell, I'll put me together a damn blockade. Hit 'em where it hurts. They control the food? Well, there ain't going to be no food. Not for anybody in this whole damn town. It's a goddamn monument to inhumanity. Let them starve. Biggest favor anyone's ever done this hellhole.
That's just what they want. You be driving the city to eat each other.
I don't like this place. Whole strip, really. Ever since I got here, the stink of it has flooded my nostrils. But you got a point. They're already hell-bent on depravity here. All I'd be doing is helping them along. All right. Well, I promised you I'd make it worth your while. So here you are. Try not to lose it all at the same casino.
And now, I am idolized on the Strip. Renowned for your extensive support and goodwill, you are idolized by the community. So, two idolizations in one video. That's pretty impressive. And now comes what I need to do for the next upgrade. Let's see. Alright, so barter is now up to 70 so I can get better deals. I put explosives to 60, so now we can finally go and pay a visit to that vault and get that quest out of the way. Guns is at 65, so I can still get a bit better aiming since I really didn't have anything else to pump it into. Lockpicks at 100, medicine I put up to 75 so I can get better statistics, and also because it was at 3 and I just want everything to go back to increments of 5. Nothing really else I really wanted to spend that last point on. I guess I could have gone with survival, but then again, it's completely useless, and I really don't like it as much, as you've come to know throughout this entire series, so I decided to put it in on unarmed, because after what happened in this video, yeah, I probably should up unarmed a little bit. But that is done. We have finished our work here for all the casinos. And now we are idolized by everyone. Well,
everyone on the strip. Everyone out in the wasteland, well, most everyone still hates my guts, but, you know, it's nice to have a little safe haven if ever anything decides to go haywire. But that is pretty much gonna do it. Before I do anything, I want to go check something, because I know there might be in something.
I've heard that elite units are on the way to support our armies here. Howdy. Interested in a refreshing beverage?
Nope, alright. I thought there was a quest line, like a little unmarked quest here, but apparently not, so yeah, that's gonna do it. Next time on Fallout New Vegas, we are gonna head out into the wasteland, and we are going to finally do that quest that I have been putting on the back burner for far too long. It's not over here. It's back over here. It's another vault. It's actually the second to last vault we're gonna be going into.
Go!
I also probably should go pick up Eddie and Arcade back from the Ultra Lux. So, until then, I will see you guys next time. Later! We got a few things to cover in this Alternates and Extras, all of which take place in the Ultra Lux, but before we get started, let's hold up a sec and backtrack a little. See this sharp-dressed fellow sitting outside the monorail station? Well, he has a quest I completely glossed over in the main LP. His plight is for you to go into the Lux and make Heck Gunderson suffer for the troubles he's been given to other ranchers. And this quest somewhat ties into the other endings to Beyond the Beef, which is what I'm going to talk about right now. To even get the opportunity to take the different routes for Beyond the Beef, you will need to either pass a speech check, have the cannibal perk, or have evil karma and non-neutral strip reputation. If you have any of those, then talk to Mortimer about the White Glove's cannibalism to be given a different option.
You're sorry for them. Good. And you know what it is to be discreet in matters of nutrition. Perhaps you can help me. I'm in a bind. I've been planning an exquisite society dinner, but there's a bit of a problem with the main course. He's got a powerful and temperamental father. Yes, the wrong person. We scouted the right one for weeks, the heir to a mercantile empire, sort of a black sheep. He cut ties with his family and left their estate to wander. He was ideal, corn-fed and well-to-do, but no one to miss him if he were to disappear. Unfortunately, the trap my subordinates set for him failed, and as he escaped, he saw their faces. Now he's wary. I asked for a last-minute replacement. And they stole the son of the most dangerous Brahmin baron in New Vegas while he stayed at this very hotel. Needless to say, this could be a disaster if things aren't put back the way they should be. And I still need somebody reputable to serve for dinner. Strictly speaking, we're no longer allowed to eat people. But I'm hoping the right person and preparation might sway Marjorie to see things my way.
Option A is to get Ted out of the Ultra Lux without killing him. Once you do so, head out into the wasteland and travel a bit north of Crimson Caravan until you find this fellow, Carlisle Sinclair. He will be our substitute meat for Ted, and all you need to do is knock him out with either the cattle prod that Mortimer gave you, or one of the comedic number of checks that will immediately take care of him and toss him into the nearby dumpster. You can pass a guns check to pistol whip him, knocking him out, pass a strength check to put him into a sleeper hold, medicine to have him take deep breaths to do the job, just go with it, unarmed to basically do a Vulcan nerve pinch, speech to trick him into going to the Ultra Lux willingly, or if you're playing as a female character, use the Black Widow perk to do the trick.
I've heard of them. Ultra Lux, right? Yeah, that'd be a... Yeah? Okay, maybe I will. Hell, anything's better than this. Thanks.
Once that's done, return to Mortimer, and the job is complete.
Of his own volition? My goodness, you are very professional, aren't you? Well, be sure to be a hit at our next banquet. You have done very well in keeping this business low-key. I appreciate your discretion.
The other, and personally more fun way for the cannibal side, is to kill Ted and frame his father for the murder, taking care of both this quest and the feeble will, raking in a decent number of caps. But how do you do it? Well, head into the kitchen and this time kill Ted. After murdering him, collect his blood from his body and then head back up to the lobby.
go around Mortimer's desk and take the elevator to the suite that his father is staying in. There are a couple of guards in there, but they shouldn't be too much of an issue. After dealing with them, head up the stairs into the bed and bathroom, splashing Ted's blood all over the bed and sink. Then head out to the strip and talk to any of the nearby Securitrons to frame Heck for the murder, leading to a nice little scene.
Heck Gunderson, you're under arrest for the murder of Ted Gunderson.
What in blazes? That's my son you're talking about. He ain't dead. I'm looking for him.
It is my duty to inform you that murder is a serious crime. As a murderer, you should be feeling emotions such as guilt, sorrow, and shame. If not, you may wish to consult a mental health professional.
Where's my son? What'd you do with my boy?
I hope this experience has taught you an important lesson about the value of human life.
You can't do this to me. This is a mistake.
Dead or alive, you're coming with me.
The hell I will.
Stand back, citizens. Deceased bodies are a known source of illness and a potential tripping hazard.
After that, head back to Mortimer and mission done.
So the Baron has slaughtered his last brother. How delightful. He was a pox on our business. He would have driven the price of beef down to the point where any poor wretch could afford it. Can you imagine? But now we can price it even higher. Create a new luxury market. Not for you, of course. You'll get a special discount.
One last thing to point out. If you don't feel like going all the way out to St. Clair's place, or feel like you're getting on bad terms with one of your companions, well, then you can actually sacrifice any human companions, so Boone, Veronica, Cass, Arcade, to the White Gloves, which will permanently kill them, of course. Now let's head back to the monorail station and inform Walter of Heck or Ted's deaths, netting you a fair share of caps.
You have? What are you waiting for, kid? Spill the beans. Yeehaw! Now that's something I thought I'd never hear. This deserves a good compensation, kid. How does that sound? I'm a man of my word. Here's your money. You've earned it.
But if you want to keep your hands clean of murder, then you can talk to Walter's wife, and she will ask you to convince her husband of just letting go and leaving, resolving the quest peacefully, but with not as many caps.
Side before the stampede tramples you over. If that's what you want to talk about, go see Walter. He'll talk your ear off. Everything he says about the evils of Heck Gunderson is true. But I've never held the notion that fighting evil with evil carries the world forward. I don't suppose you have the magic powers necessary to bring my husband to his senses, do you? He swears he won't leave this godforsaken city until he's seen Heck suffer. So far as I can see, we're the only ones in pain. That's very kind of you. Maybe this'll be the dawn of a new day.
Hell, a good thrashing is what I want to give them. But I see your point, kid. Things will never change without us good folks. All right, I'm gonna get Ethel far away from this damn city and head back home. There's a worthy life waiting for us there. Thanks for your help, kid. So long.
And that's all there is to it. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you all next time.